Today we are going to be taking a look at the stunt driver extraordinaire STU. In this video you will learn everything you possibly can about STU. I will even be covering how to double, triple, and even quadruple dash with him. Let's go and begin. So for STU's gadget, he has two. The first one we're going to talk about is speed zone. So when you guys activate this gadget, he's going to go ahead and drop a turret that is going to speed up you and your team. This turret will drop a speed boost of a radius of 6.67 tiles. The turret will have 1000 health, but it will decay by 30 HP every single second. And just keep in mind, the turret speed boost buffs do not really work on spawnables like the Nita Bear or Mr. P Porters, for example. Now when you guys are placing down your speed zone gadget, it's important you guys try to place it behind an obstacle or something that can protect it. Since it does have decay, it's going to be destroyed anyway, but you want to keep it alive as long as possible. Or for example, say you guys are playing Siege, it's going to be great to use that gadget right at the start of the match. Mostly because if STU uses that gadget at the beginning of the game, then you guys are going to get that speed boost and it's going to make it a lot quicker for you guys to get to the middle. This gadget can be super critical when needing to get back to the choke point or wherever you guys need to be going inside of a game. Now not only is this gadget going to be good for like speeding up you and your teammates, but it's also going to be good for tanking high singular projectile shots, kind of like tanking a shot from like a Piper or a Mandy. If you guys know that a shot is pretty much going to hit you, you guys can go ahead and pop this gadget and use it to tank the shot for you. Now yes, theoretically this isn't the most ideal way to be using speed zone, but it is a great way to help you stay alive. Alright, now STU's second gadget is going to be breakthrough. Now upon activation, STU's next super can destroy obstacles. For every wall tile that is destroyed, 3 pieces of flying debris are going to go straight forward in a cone direction, kind of like Penny. And if you do manage to connect with any flying debris, it's going to do 200 damage per debris. Now this gadget is going to be more ideal on maps where you need to break open the map, expose some of the enemies that you guys are playing against. Say for example, you guys are playing against tanks, assassins, throwers. It's going to be great for you guys to break open the map and expose them. Also, if there's people hiding behind walls and you know you can break them, just go ahead and do that. If they're pretty much low or you know they're going to die, then you can go ahead and break that gadget, hit them with the flying debris, and get them down with your main attacks. This is going to be great, for example, like when you're playing Brawl Ball and there's a massive wall blocking the way, kind of like in Backyard Bowl, for example. You can go in and use Breakthrough to break through those walls, and it's going to make it a lot easier for you guys to score goals. Now, an extra bonus tip with Breakthrough, if you guys are going to be using the Zero Drag Star Power, it's actually going to help you break even more walls. If you guys are breaking more walls, then there'll be more flying debris that can possibly hit the enemies and the more damage you're going to be doing. If you're playing on a map that has a lot of walls and you want to break as much as possible, I'd recommend using Zero Drag combined with the Breakthrough gadget. Now, speaking of Zero Drag, let's go ahead and talk about STU's star power, Zero Drag. Now, when you guys use Zero Drag, STU's super dash is going to be extended. It's going to be increased from 2.33 tiles to 4 tiles. Now, it may not sound like a lot, but trust me, it's going to make it so much easier when you guys need to be dodging incoming attacks. Now, like I stated, this star power is going to be more ideal if you guys struggle with dodging. So, if you guys think that Zero Drag is going to benefit you because you'll be traveling farther, then I'd recommend using this star power to help you guys dodging incoming attacks. This star power will also help you just be more chaotic throughout the game. Like if you're just dashing all over the place, the enemy team is going to be all frazzled and they're not going to really know what to do. But this star power is very solid as well, because if you're really good at chaining supers with STU, it's going to help you travel across the map a lot faster. If you guys need to get closer to choke points, you guys need to catch up with enemies, this is going to be a great star power for you guys to run. Now what I do like about this star power as well is when you guys play STU in Brawl Ball, you can self pass the ball to yourself. This is why STU is going to be a very good like hard carry brawler in a game mode, especially like Brawl Ball. But even if you guys use STU in Siege with Zero Drag, like it's going to make it so much easier for you guys to collect bows and you can just grab a bow and dash out. Now another positive thing about Zero Drag is in case like tanks or assassins get close to you, then you'll be able to dash away from them and they're not going to be able to catch up to you. It's just a great way to escape or get in and out like very quickly. So if you guys are creative and you guys want to be dashing all over the place with STU, I'd recommend going Zero Drag. Now I know I said all these amazing things about Zero Drag, but hear me out about Gasu Heal. Now if you guys use Gasu Heal, every time you use your super, STU is going to heal up for 400 HP. Now the reason I like Gasu Heal as well is because it helps you guys maintain health but also maintain pressure at the same time. For example, if you guys are still trying to keep the pressure and keep control of the map and you guys are still attacking but you guys are still using your super, you guys will not get the benefit from like not attacking and then you can heal up. But if you guys use Gasu Heal every time you use your super, at least you'll be gaining some health back. Since with STU it's so easy for him to charge his super, you guys might as well use Gasu Heal so you can gain some health back every time you use your super. Now I would highly recommend this star power if you guys are very good at like double dashing with STU. The only reason I say this is because if you guys are very consistent with double dashing, you guys can gain, instead of 400 health, you guys can gain 800 health every time you use your super. Now STU has to be one of the best brawlers in charging his super because you literally get your super from one attack. This specific mechanic with STU makes him a very mobile and very versatile pick in whatever game mode or map you guys play him on. I mean, being able to charge your super after one attack and then you can use that super to go and dodge enemies, like it's just so broken. With STU gaining his super with literally hitting a person only one time, it makes it super easy for him to charge his super and he can basically cycle supers very quickly. quickly. This will give him more opportunities to dodge incoming attacks or just run around the map like a crazy person. Now, something that the really good STU players do is kind of poking people with his main attack and his super. What I mean by this is you just use your main attack and then you dash away because you know the enemy's probably going to try and hit you at the same time. And as long as you guys are connecting onto the enemy team, this is why poking and dashing is super effective with him. You can continuously just keep on trying to chip the enemy down and keep on dodging at the same time. And if you guys are using the Ghastly Heal star power like I stated, bro, you guys are never gonna die. Now, once you guys are chipping them down and they are starting to get a little bit lower, that is when instead of dodging away, you can start dashing towards them to go and finish them off. And when you guys are playing STU, I'd highly recommend you guys play him in 1v1 situations, mostly because his attacks don't really pierce a whole ton and he doesn't really do the highest amount of DPS as well. And it kind of goes along with the previous tip that I was talking about. With STU, you kind of want to just be poking and chipping people down from a distance. And then once they finally get low enough where you can dash onto them, that is when you strike and take your opportunity. Now, although STU has the easiest super to charge in the entire game, it's going to be very important that you guys have a super ready to use on standby. For example, if you guys need to dash away and heal up with Ghastly Heal, it's going to help you guys in that kind of sense. But also, if you guys need to break a wall and you have a super on standby to use, you can go ahead and pop that breakthrough gadget and you will have a super ready to use to break that wall down. Or even if you guys know that you're going to be pressured in a high intense situation, if you guys have a super ready to use, you can go ahead and get ready to dash away before the enemy team has a chance to even strike on you. There's a lot of other scenarios why you need to be having a super ready to use on standby, but just make sure you guys always have one throughout the game. Now, a little secret bonus tip I'm gonna tell you guys, if you guys plan on maining STU for quite a bit and plan on grinding a lot of trophies with him, I'd recommend making your super button as big as possible, mostly because you're gonna be wanting to use your super a lot because it's a main important part of his mechanics. So I'd highly recommend you guys go up here and check out my video where I talk about like how to basically change up your controls. And especially if you guys want to practice your double dashing, triple dashing, or even quadruple dashing, it's important your button is as big as possible so you make sure you hit it every time. Now, the moment of the video you guys have probably all been waiting for is how to even do a double dash, triple dash, or a quadruple dash. Now, whenever you guys are planning to do some kind of like crazy dash chain, it's important you guys always start off with your super. Now, yes, you can technically do some double dash and triple dashing without having your super to start off with, but it's just going to be a lot easier when you're first starting off with training this mechanic. Now, the first step is going to be, yes, you guys want to be starting off with your super. Now, the second tip, right before your first attack hits, you want to go ahead and use your super. This way, right as your attack lands, you will have your next super ready to use. So the order you guys want to be going is use your super, use your main attack, use your super, and then your main attack again. Now, this is what you call a double dash. Now, if you guys can go even faster, you guys can do a triple dash as well. But when you guys use a triple dash, you guys are going to need at least 2 bars of ammo ready to use. Now, it's basically the same thing as a double dash, so you guys want to be using your super, then main attack, super, then main attack, super, and then main attack again. You guys need to be super quick when you guys are switching between your main attack and your super, so I'd highly recommend you guys go into the training grounds and practice this first. If you guys go into a match and you guys try to practice this in real time against opponents, it's going to be pretty hard for you guys to get it at first. Mostly because at least if you guys practice it in training grounds, nothing is going to be moving, but when you play in a real game, obviously people are going to be moving around. Now, if you guys can go even faster and you guys got the triple dash down, you guys can try and attempt the quadruple dash. Now, it's going to be the same thing for the double dash and the triple dash, but the only difference is that you guys are going to need 3 bars of ammo first off, and secondly, when you guys use your last bar of ammo, you guys need to be using another dash before the second firework lands on your opponent. Now, this is why the quadruple dash is very hard to execute, because you need to have a very fast finger. If you guys don't have very fast fingers when you guys are tapping your super button, it's going to be very difficult for you guys to hit that super button before the second firework lands. Now, the order you guys are going to be going for the quadruple dash is super, main attack, super, main attack, super, main attack, and before the second firework lands, super, main attack very quickly. Now, the reason I really wanted to go over dashing with STU is because it's super important when like trying to disrupt timing from enemies' incoming attacks. It's also going to be good to kind of confuse them and frazzle them whenever you guys are playing in a real game. You're going to be dashing all over the place and they're not going to really be able to hit you. But it's also going to be very fun and effective, because if you guys can consistently get your dashing down, it's going to really frustrate the enemy team because you're just going to be going all over the place and they're not going to really be able to hit you. But training dashing with STU is very vital to your overall mechanics as a Brawl Stars player, because it's going to train you guys to have faster reactions and a faster finger. So go ahead, practice in the training grounds. I wish you guys the best of luck and let me know how it goes in the comments down below. Well, anyway guys, I think that's going to go ahead and conclude today's video. Mahalo nui loa, ahui ho, see you guys in the next one.